Hi there folks, this is a very quick video that I thought I would make after posting a question on Twitter about NTFS permissions and share permissions in Windows Server. Now the question read, a user called Bill needs to access a folder called marketing data over the network. What permission does Bill have to the marketing data folder? So if we take a look at the diagram, we can see that we have NTFS permissions and we have share permissions. Now the NTFS permissions read, the sales group have read only permission assigned to them. Now Bill isn't a member of the sales group, so we can disregard that. The marketing group have modified permission. Now Bill is a member of the marketing group, so we know that Bill has been assigned modified permission so far. But Bill as a user has also been assigned full control. Now, NTFS permissions are known as cumulative, and that means the permissions add up. So the marketing group with modified permission can be added to the full control permission. Now, in reality, full control already contains modify, and full control is the most powerful permission. Now the only exception to this rule is if you ever see a deny permission. Deny always takes precedence over everything. So from an NTFS permission point of view, Bill has full control to the marketing data folder. However, the important thing to bear in mind here is Bill is accessing the folder not locally, but he's accessing it over a network through a network share. Now that means share permissions come into play. And as we can see, the everyone group, which Bill is a member of, has read-only permissions assigned to it. So what we have here is a real conflict in terms of our permissions. NTFS permissions say Bill has full control, but share permissions say that everyone, including Bill, has read-only. So what effective permission does Bill have? Well, there's a really easy and simple rule. The most restrictive permission applies. So as we can see, the everyone group, which Bill is a member of, has read-only permission. And read-only is more restrictive than modify and full control. So read-only wins. Now this is quite an interesting little question, and it does confuse people because this is something you will see a lot. You will see this combination of share permissions and NTFS permissions that differ. Because share permissions are very basic, whereas NTFS permissions allow us as network administrators to assign very granular and specific permissions. So it is really important to understand the difference between the two and be aware of this rule. I think it was quite an interesting little question, and I hope you enjoyed it. And I plan to make some more videos like this if you find them beneficial and enjoy them. If you do, don't forget, please give the video a thumbs up and drop a comment below. And also, if you haven't subscribed to the IT Taster channel yet, please hit the subscribe button and remember to hit the notification bell to receive alerts of new content. So as always, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.